good to be here this morning. And it all started with me already a long time ago in the early 90s, when I had been a pastor in church, and I realized how many even church people are struggling to deal with suffering in their lives, especially losses and trauma, and also how things that are happening with people have an impact on marriage relationships. And in my first congregation as a pastor, I also experienced trauma in my own life, and I struggled to deal with it. And as life goes on, and I got also in a second congregation where I had been exposed to community work with the whole thing of you do not live only for yourself. What you receive, you give out to other people. You make a difference in other people's lives. And I realized how important it is to make this what you receive in life. The lessons that you have learned in life in difficulties, to share it with other people. And it comes from 2 Corinthians chapter 1. In the first few verses, you will read something of that also there. And then I got into the trauma world, became specialized in this area, and especially in terms of traumatic child death and how to help parents to go through this after child death. And I ended up in Israel, where I studied further in resilience and in a country where people and children are always exposed to trauma. And then I brought resilience to Namibia, and the Trauma Healing Network is part of that, to bring hope and healing for people from the Bible, from a biblical spirituality, help people to survive difficulties. And yes, and there is something that we have to know, that we don't necessarily are born with resilience. It can be developed in yourself. In Israel, they develop children from 9 years old to develop their own resilience. And yes, God created us with an inborn emergency system to work through a lot of stuff in our lives. But we always need more development in resilience. How to manage our difficulties well, how to cope, how to bounce back, how to bounce forward, and how to get more persevere in difficulties, to go through it and survive it. So that is difficult also for Christian people and church people. And I want to share with you the story of this Himba lady behind me, and I'm so glad to see Oma also here. She's also went through some of our trainings already, and it's big thing for me is to bring high specialized trauma knowledge to the bottom, that people even in the bush can experience something of it. And this Himba lady, when we had a healing retreat in north of Opu, deep into the bush, for the first time in her life, she could talk about 3 losses in her life, and her pain, exactly the same pain of people in the city, now, although she's in the bush. And we have a very good trained Ochereru facilitator, and she's very good in our program. And she helped this lady to talk about her pain. She lost, actually what happened, she sent out the children to look after the cattle in the field. And at that stage, her sister's son was also part of this group of children, and this little boy landed up in a deep pit of water and he drowned. And she had to communicate this bad message to her sister. That is it was a very difficult situation for her, because she felt very guilty. And just 3 weeks after that, her own little girl became very sick and died because of that sickness. And her husband then accused her of negligence, and then he divorced her. So she was at that stage not in a good place in her life. She went to witch doctors that made it worse, and eventually she ended up with Christ through Kundalini for Christ, and ended up in our healing retreat. So that is still a story. And just to end up, my need is to see, and that is my big dream for Namibia, to see more people being equipped in resilient skills, that they can be stronger people to deal with difficulties in life, so that they eventually can be equipped to support others emotionally when they are going through bad stuff in their life, so that we have a stronger community. Although we are the land of the brave, but a lot of people just walk away as if nothing happened, and they don't really deal with it, and they end up with a lot of bad, unhealthy coping methods. That's my story. Thank you.